On December 17th at noon local time in Indonesia, the alert level was simultaneously raised at two stratovolcanoes on the island of Flores, going from green to yellow or 1 to 2. The reason for this raising of both peaks' alert levels is that somewhat like the Three Sisters stratovolcanoes in the U.S. state of Oregon, the two peaks were part of a singular volcanic complex known as Lewotobi, which happened to share a singular joint magma chamber at depth. Both the Laki Laki and Parampuan stratovolcanoes, along with the flank vent known as Iliwokor, are part of the Lewotobi volcanic complex and not the similarly named Lewotolok volcano. The more active and shorter of the two stratovolcanoes is the Laki Laki cone, which has produced 20 historical eruptions since the 15th century. On the other hand, the taller and less active Parampuan stratovolcano has only erupted twice in 1921 and 1935. Parampuan's central peak contains a highly altered lava dome which was in place during the 1921 eruption and has a composition of andesite. The Iliwokor flank vent has not produced any confirmed historical eruptions, but due to its youthful appearance, in my opinion, has probably erupted several times during the last 5,000 years. Lewotobi as a whole is a fairly explosive volcano which frequently ejects long-traveling bombs of lava and blocks of volcanic debris which have during past eruptions struck the ground as far as 6 kilometers or 3.73 miles from the erupting peak. Pyroclastic flows are also a hazard which have occurred during some past eruptions that generate volcanic explosions, along with less frequent andesite lava flows which seem to occur in about 1 in every 4 eruptions. Seismic activity has been increasing at Lewotobi since approximately 1 month ago. Between November 17th and December 3rd, the number of volcanic earthquakes increased from an average of 1 to 2 a day to an average of 4 a day. 3 harmonic tremors were subsequently detected on December 5th, indicating either the movement of magma or magmatic gases. After this occurred, the number of earthquakes returned to background levels. They once again increased on December 12th, increasing to a 3-month high on December 15th, and spiked to unusually high levels the following day. Of the earthquakes in the last 48 hours around Lewotobi, 5 were what are called tornillo events, which are a type of low-frequency and low-amplitude earthquakes which generally indicate the movement of magma. While it is not exactly clear which of the two main cones this activity was centered around, it appears more likely to be centered underneath the Laki Laki cone. Yet, because we are not sure which cone magma is potentially actively rising underneath, the alert level of both peaks were raised. The last week represents Lewotobi's first volcanic unrest episode since March of 2015, and its 6th episode of unrest since it last erupted in September of 2003. However, just because there has been a fairly lengthy period since Lewotobi's last unrest does not mean if an eruption were to occur that it would be larger or more explosive than typical. However, the vast majority of Lewotobi's eruptions do seem to occur in 1 to 8 year long clusters, only to be followed by 7 to 29 years of no eruptions. What I am trying to say is that if Lewotobi does end up erupting due to its current unrest, it will be likely to erupt again at some point in the next 4 years. Due to the average eruption size this volcano produces being a VEI-2 on the 0 to 9 Volcanic Explosivity Index, a 2 kilometer exclusion zone was declared in all directions around the summits of the Laki Laki and Parampuan volcanic cones. Evacuations, which have historically occurred up to a radius of 7 kilometers from this volcano, could also be triggered if Lewotobi was to eventually erupt. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.